Today, of course, is Friday the 13th, and there is also a full moon outside, the first such occurrence in 14 years, all of which leads to a rather appropriate story for this day. For years, things that go bump in the night have meant high ratings and high camp for local television stations. Scott Osbourne takes a look at those individuals who make truly bad movies good TV viewing.
Welcome, welcome back to Late Night Fright Theater.
Oh, good evening.
Hometown stations have created a monster. They've transformed normal folks into masters of ceremonies who have become horribly successful, usually.
Well, now, my baby loves a monster movie. My baby loves a monster movie. My baby loves a monster movie. And she watches on TV.
Local horror hosts of every imaginable description have been lurking about since the mid-1950s, when horror films were unveiled on television. And these days, even more candidates are dying to sign on, queuing up for auditions and taking their cues from the old masters.
Now, I hope you're paying attention so that you can learn a thing or two. I tell you the story of my old friend, Dracula.
One of the first hosts to take a bite out of the audience, Roland.
Well, in Philadelphia, we were doing a cowboy show, a live cowboy show, horses, all that stuff. And one week, I played an undertaker. And they remembered that, and when the films were released for TV, they said, hey, you want to do this? And I never tried out for it or anything. And it worked.
Picking up stakes and moving to New York, he assumed his own name.
Oh. Ah, there you are. Been waiting for you. Long time. This is Zacherle here.
Zacherle is one of the real survivors, but there's a generation of new horror hosts.
Oh, come in. Don't be afraid. I won't bite, and you're bound to have a good time. Or my name isn't Elvira.
When people watch the show, I don't think they're watching for the movies. Some people are, because some people are bad film aficionados like myself. But I think the majority of people that watch, from the mail I get anyway, tune in to see me say what they are saying at home.
Shoulda shown one of those Filipino vampire jobs.
Yeah, shoulda, woulda, coulda.
Los Angeles actress Cassandra Peterson has fashioned Elvira into an attractive package. She's materialized in more than 50 TV markets and boasts a line of T-shirts, bumper stickers, greeting cards, records, and buttons. A nice story. Local ghoul makes good. Elvira has some deadly competition, however.
Good evening, my darklings.
Lucretia, we really must get together again. For sure, for sure.
Good evening, and welcome to Theater of the Macabre.
I don't think I want to hear this.
Different-looking hosts have popped up across the country. Some play it straight.
Welcome to my kingdom of darkness and light.
Others go for the jugular with humor.
Don't forget, National Duck Day is around the corner.
Of course, there are the traditionalists.
Let's go, come!
Those who take off with elaborate costumes.
Up in the sky, it's a bird!
It's a plane!
No, it's Super Host!
And there are hosts who are simply laid back.
And we hope that you enjoyed seeing our drive-in movie special tonight from the great open-air drive-in theater here at Night Owl Theater. Basically, I've always been an iconoclast, and I just feel that movies are not the holy grail. A movie is a movie is a movie, and true, some of them are art, but you just really can't take them or anything that seriously, so it's fun to kind of puncture the balloon just a trifle.
A favorite pastime of horror hosts, poking fun at movies and television shows.
When there's nobody home in the neighborhood, we visit someone who's got stuff that's good and steal it. We can steal it.
But the most fun local horror hosts have is at their own expense.
Where can I voice off as a movie this week?
Well, how do you like the movie so far?
Well, me and my girlfriend, we love watching horror movies.
Me and my boyfriend on a Friday night.
In many ways, hosting horror and science fiction movies is a throwback to the simpler days of television.
In a way, we're kind of a Tyrannosaurus Rex of the business. There are fewer and fewer of us around the country.
The budgets are minuscule, the sets are jerry-rigged, but for four decades, those local horror movie hosts have provided a human touch. Well, almost human.
Stagehand, wave goodbye to everybody.
Catch you next time.
Good night, whatever you are.
Next up, the
WEVV-TV, Evansville.